In this lesson, we will derive a form of the Navier-Stokes equations that is valid for Newtonian fluids in an incompressible isothermal flow. In prior videos, we derived the differential form of the conservation of mass equation for a control volume, also called the continuity equation, as well as the three conservation of linear momentum equations for a control volume, also called the Navier-Stokes equations. We also noted that the viscous shear stresses are symmetric for small fluid elements. Currently, we have 4 conservation equations, but 11 unknowns. The 3 velocity components, u, v, and w, the density rho, pressure p, and 6 viscous stresses. We have too many unknowns, so we must make some assumptions about the flow in order to reduce the number of unknowns. The constitutive relations allow us to relate the viscous stresses to strain rates, which are expressed in terms of velocity gradients. And it should be noted that the remaining part of this derivation of the Navier-Stokes equations has been simplified somewhat to be appropriate for an undergraduate fluid mechanics course. In order to use the constitutive relations, we need to make some assumptions about the flow. First, we assume the fluid is Newtonian. This means the viscous stresses tau are proportional to the strain rates epsilon. In prior videos, we derived expressions for the strain rates in terms of velocity gradients. The second assumption is that the fluid is isotropic. This means the relationship between viscous stresses and strain rates does not depend on orientation. For example, here are 2 fluid elements experiencing the same shear stress tau. If the fluid is isotropic, the rate of deformation, or the strain rate, of the 2 fluid elements will be the same. The last assumption is that the fluid is incompressible, which means the density does not change significantly in time and space. In a prior video, we showed that for incompressible flows, the differential form of the conservation of mass equation becomes the divergence of the velocity field, del dot v equals 0. Given these assumptions, it can be shown that the viscous stress, tau ij, is equal to 2 times the absolute viscosity mu times the strain rate, epsilon ij. A derivation of this relationship can be found in graduate-level fluid mechanics textbooks. For viscous stresses, where the subscripts I and j are different, we have the following relationships. We've already mentioned that the shear stresses are symmetric. Tau xy is equal to tau yx, tau yz is equal to tau zy, and tau xz is equal to tau zx. The constitutive relations give that tau xy is equal to 2 times the viscosity times epsilon xy. Tau yz is equal to 2 times the viscosity times epsilon yz, and tau xz is equal to 2 times viscosity times epsilon xz. In a prior video, we derived expressions for the shear strain rate in terms of velocity gradients. Epsilon xy is equal to 1/2 partial u partial y plus partial v partial x. Epsilon yz is equal to 1/2 partial v partial z plus partial w partial y. And epsilon xz is equal to 1/2 partial u partial z plus partial w partial x. The 1/2 cancels out, and we now have the shear stresses in terms of the velocity gradients. For the viscous stresses, where I and j are the same, we have the following relationships for tau xx, tau yy, and tau zz. Tau xx is equal to 2 times the viscosity epsilon xx. Tau yy is equal to 2 times viscosity times epsilon yy. And tau zz is equal to 2 times viscosity times epsilon zz. In a prior video, we derived expressions for the linear strain rate in terms of velocity gradients. Epsilon xx is equal to partial u partial x, epsilon yy is equal to partial v partial y, and epsilon zz is equal to partial w partial z. So now we have expressions for all the viscous stresses in terms of velocity gradients and the viscosity mu. We are now down to 5 unknowns. the three velocity components, U, V, and W, the pressure P, and the viscosity, mu. In many applications, the temperature does not change much throughout the flow, and so the flow can be approximated as isothermal. For isothermal flows, we can approximate the viscosity as constant, since viscosity is mostly impacted by temperature. If the flow is not isothermal, and viscosity was variable, we would need to incorporate the differential form of the conservation energy equation as well. After plugging in the expressions for the viscous stresses and rearranging some terms, we arrive at the Navier-Stokes equations for a Newtonian fluid that has constant density and viscosity. The Navier-Stokes equation in the x direction is density times the quantity partial u partial t plus u partial x plus v partial u partial y plus w partial u partial z equals density times the gravitational acceleration in the x direction minus partial pressure partial x plus mu times the quantity second derivative of u with respect to x plus a second derivative of u with respect to y plus a second derivative of u with respect to z. The Navier-Stokes equation in the y direction is density times the quantity partial v partial t plus u partial v partial x plus v partial y plus w partial v partial z equals density times the gravitational acceleration in the y direction minus partial pressure partial y plus mu times the quantity second derivative of v with respect to x plus second derivative of v with respect to y plus the second derivative of v with respect to z. And finally, the Navier-Stokes equation in the z direction is density times the quantity partial w partial t plus u times partial w partial x plus v partial w partial y plus w partial z equals density times the gravitational acceleration in the z direction minus partial pressure partial z plus mu times the quantity second derivative of w with respect to x plus second derivative of w with respect to y plus the second derivative of w with respect to z. These equations are valid for a rectangular coordinate system, and similar equations for cylindrical and spherical coordinate systems can be found in fluid mechanics textbooks. The three equations can be rewritten more compactly as one vector equation in the following manner. Density times the quantity partial velocity vector partial t plus the velocity vector dot del operator operating on the velocity vector equals density times the gravitational acceleration vector minus the gradient of pressure plus the viscosity times the Laplacian of the velocity vector. The Navier-Stokes equations are a set of nonlinear coupled partial differential equations which describe the flow field at all points in space. They are very important foundational equations in fluid mechanics. But unfortunately, we can't find an analytical solution to these equations except for systems with relatively simple geometries and flow conditions. For example, while the Navier-Stokes equations can be used for laminar or turbulent flows, we can only find an analytical solution if the flow is laminar because, if the flow were turbulent, the velocity would contain a component that fluctuates randomly in time. Predicting flow patterns for complicated geometries and flow conditions can be accomplished using computational fluid dynamics software, which uses numerical methods to solve the equations.